Saturday's edition of The Wire Wrap is brought to you by Exit Realty, Bob Lamb & Associates, Greg Goff, Auctioneer & Realtor. Check out his ad today at the top of the Cannon Wire. The Junkle was a busy place to be today as the barbecue patch was going on and the Junior Lions were in the playoff. The CCHS Lions football boosters were busy dishing out the beans, barbecue, and a whole lot of fun for everyone, raising money for the football team. They even had some cakes, pies, and cookies and a whole lot of Lions football merchandise. So contact one of the boosters to get yourself decked out in maroon and gold and support the Lions. Some couldn't get enough of football action and started their own game behind the boosters. There were several games going on today in the Lions den and games were running about an hour behind. It seemed like everywhere there were We Believe posters, in town, on the field, and anywhere you looked. The Baxter Rebels played the Watertown Purple Tigers today just before the Junior Lions team. It was a really hard-fought game. Of course, the cheerleaders were working as hard as the football players, getting the crowd revved up. Then the older Junior Lions played the Watertown Purple Tigers.
Richard on the tackle, fumble on the play. Recovered by Josh Walker. The first down for Cannon County Lions on their own 26-yard line. Spencer Lahue.
The Short Mountain VFD is going to have a ham breakfast on November the 7th. Then today was the Cannon County Walking Horse Association's annual fall ride. They left out from the campgrounds on Short Mountain Road for several hours, and then we caught them coming back in. They had a drawing for CCWHA merchandise, and it appeared that everyone had a great time.
Ticket number 4, 9, 8, 6, 7.
Several of the campsites were even decorated for Halloween, and a costume contest was to be held later, plus trick-or-treating for the kids. Even though it's fall on the mountain, Short Mountain that is, there were some wildflowers still in bloom. Why drive to East Tennessee when you can get a better view right here in Cannon County? Believe it or not, if you drive on Highway 146, you can see some longhorn cattle, buffalo, and ostrich that will be outside grazing. This little spot is right across the road from Short Mountain Bible Camp. One thing that happened that we missed, at about 5:30 p.m. this evening, a single vehicle injury accident occurred at Parsley's Market on John Bragg Highway. It was reported that a woman ran off the road and into the median. She reportedly was taken to Stones River ER for evaluation by Cannon County EMS. Overall, it's been a beautiful fall day in Cannon County. This is Cannon Wire reporting from Short Mountain, Tennessee with Saturday's edition of the Wire Wrap.